If you're considering condo living, parking is an important thing to understand. Watch this video for 6 things you need to know about condo parking. Hi, I'm Jen McFilmy, Real Estate Associate Realtor with Yegg Pro Realty. Welcome to my Downtown Dwellers series, where I will be providing you information and insight from a downtown dweller's perspective. Parking is something many people overlook. They think, well, as long as I have a spot, good enough. This is where the heartache begins. If you want to avoid regret in your next condo purchase, then you need to know the different parking situations with condos. In this video, I'm going to provide you with 6 things you must know about condo parking. But before we get started, go ahead and click that subscribe button and that little bell so you don't miss out on my new videos posted weekly. Okay, so getting right into it. Number 1, understanding the type of parking stall you'll get with your condo. So there are 3 types of stalls for condos. 1 is an underground stall, 2 is a surface parking stall, and 3 is a covered surface parking stall. Basically, a surface stall is located at ground level, and you'll find it in a lot beside the condo or right out front of your unit, depending on what kind of condo you're purchasing. The only difference between a surface stall and a covered surface stall is that it's covered. So yeah, it has a roof, but no walls. An underground stall, you guessed it, is located underground, usually directly under the units for which the stalls are for. They usually have access to the elevator for the condo unit and may even include storage options. Underground stalls are typically more desirable than surface stalls. You could compare it to a parking pad at a single family home versus a garage at a single family home. Number 2, the type of ownership for the stall. You should find out if the stall is titled or assigned. This is very important. An assigned stall is allocated for your use. The stall assignment is at the discretion of the condo board and can be changed at any time. A titled stall means that you own the stall. Though because it is titled, it does attract property taxes and additional condo fees. Though each of these items is pretty low cost. Underground stalls are usually about $100 to $150 in property taxes per year, and might attract up to $15 per month in condo fees. This depending on your condo and the location, so definitely check those condo documents. So why does it matter if you have an assigned stall or a titled stall? Well, if it's assigned, the condo board could technically change your stall at any time. Not that they will, but they could. Also, assigned stalls may not transfer to the buyer from the seller. Definitely something you should ask your realtor to find out for you if you're buying a condo with an assigned stall. With a titled stall, you own it, so it won't move. You can also sell the stall or rent it. There may be renting restrictions, so definitely check that in the condo documents. So number 3, single stall versus tandem stall. If the condo you're buying comes with 2 stalls, it's important to find out if those are 2 separate single stalls or 1 tandem stall. If the stalls are titled, 2 separate single stalls will each come with their own title. A tandem stall will come with 1 title. A tandem stall is the same width as a single stall, but it's double the length, so you park cars front to back. So basically, if your tandem stall is against the wall and both cars are parked there, you can't get the car in the back out without moving the front car. That can be annoying sometimes. But if you have 2 vehicles, it's better than having 1 stall. Number 4, storage options. Are they allowed in your parking stall? With condo living, storage is a premium. So having an opportunity to have a storage locker in your parking stall could be a very nice option. You could store bikes, extra tires, sporting equipment, etc. Storage options on parking stalls are cages, usually at the back of the stall or in between 2 stalls, if in the middle of the parkade, and sometimes in another designated area within the parkade. If you buy a condo with an underground titled stall, ask your realtor to check to see if storage cages are allowed to be installed. Number 5, visitor parking. Visitor parking is also a very important consideration, especially if you're buying a condo in downtown. I live in a condo that was supposed to have visitor parking stalls. Unfortunately, right before we got possession, the builder changed the plans and there's no visitor parking in our building. This is super frustrating because we're located in the core of downtown. So, as you know, parking can be tough and there's no free parking unless it's after 6 or on Sundays, except on event nights. So, most times our visitors actually have to pay for parking. And number 6, parking effect on resale. So yes, parking does affect resale. Condos without parking are less desirable and will likely sell less for comparable condos that have parking. So even though there are great steps to improve the carless culture here in downtown Edmonton, most people still have cars and they need a place to park them. If you buy a condo without parking and the person has to rent a stall in the downtown core, they're looking at anywhere between $200 and $300 extra per month just for parking. Well, I hope you have a better understanding of condo parking. And if you have any other questions, please feel free to reach out to me and comment below and let me know if you think condo parking is a must or you can get away without it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you on my next video. Bye.